Greetings. This is video number 7 in the series comparing Christianity to Islam. After 3 lengthy videos documenting the glaring inconsistencies in Islam about itself, I thought I would move on. So, what does Islam say about Christianity? Islam claims Christians have a covenant with the deity they call Allah. Surah 5:14. And with those who say, "Lo, we are Christians," we made a covenant. But they forgot a part of that whereof they were admonished. But this begs some questions. When was it, the covenant, established? Who established it? What are the terms of this covenant that Christians have? Only Christians know the answers to these questions. The only covenant Christians have was established by Jesus' death on the cross. And that contradicts Islam's claim that Jesus was neither killed nor crucified. Islam claims Christians have forgotten part of their covenant. Surah 5:14 again. We made a covenant, but they forgot a part of that. But this begs the question, what part of the covenant does Islam think Christians have somehow lost or forgotten? Again, only Christians know their covenant. Islam claims Christians have exceeded their religion. Surah 5:77, "Say, O people of the Scripture, do not exceed limits in your religion beyond the truth." But the Quran never says exactly what those limits are. One may only conjecture what the limits are. Surah 4, 171. O people of the Scripture, meaning Jews and Christians, do not exceed the limits of your religion. Say not 3. Cease, it is better for you. Notice this surah lumps Jews in with Christians, saying 3 as in the Trinity. Think about it. What is wrong with claiming Jews say the Trinity? Think about it. Surah 57:27. Then we sent following their footsteps our messengers and followed them with Jesus, the son of Mary, and gave him the gospel. And we placed in the hearts of those who followed him compassion and mercy and monasticism, which they innovated. We did not prescribe it for them except seeking the approval of Allah. Islam claims Christians and Jews proclaim exclusivity. Surah 2:111. And they say, "None will enter paradise except one who is a Jew or a Christian." That is their wishful thinking. Say, "Produce your proof if you should be truthful." Notice Islam makes a claim about what Christians believe and what Jews believe, then demands Christians produce proof. But Islam never offers proof to prove itself. Islam claims Jewish and Christian thinking is wishful thinking, but offers no proof of its own claim of exclusivity. Islam claims Christians and Jews are polytheists. Surah 2:113. The Jews say the Christians have nothing to stand on, and the Christians say the Jews have nothing to stand on, although they recite the scripture. Thus the polytheists speak the same as their words. Notice, Mohammed calls the Jews polytheists. Notice Islam makes a claim about what Christians and Jews say. But Christians and Jews do not say these things. Surah 2:135. They say, "Be Jews or Christians, and you will be guided." Say, "Rather, the religion of Abraham inclining toward truth, and he was not of the polytheists. So again, Mohammed called Jews and Christians polytheists. Surah 367. Abraham was neither a Jew nor a Christian, but he was one inclining toward truth, a Muslim, and he was not of the polytheists. So Mohammed thought the Jews were polytheists. And I get a real kick out of that, that Abraham was not Jewish. Think about it. Islam trains its followers against Jews and Christians. Surah 2, 120. And never will the Jews or the Christians approve of you until you follow their religion. Say, indeed, the guidance of Allah is the guidance. If you were to follow their desires after what has come to you of knowledge, you would have against Allah no protector or helper. Mohammed was quite a schemer. This is the very way that I would try and inoculate people against listening to anticipated arguments. Surah 551. O you who have believed, do not take the Jews and Christians as allies. They are allies of one another. And whoever is an ally to them among you, then indeed he is of them. Indeed, Allah guides not the wrongdoing people. What does that mean? Why do these random thoughts appear? You can only conjecture he's trying to claim that either the Jews or the Christians or those who are an ally with them are these wrongdoing people. As if somehow being friends with Jews and Christians is the wrong thing to do. Surah 582. You will surely find the most intense of the people in animosity toward the believers, this being the code word for Muslims, to be the Jews and those who associate others with Allah. Notice this is code for Christians. And you will find the nearest of them in affection to the believers, to Muslims, those who say, we are Christians. That is because among them are priests and monks, and because they are not arrogant. Look at that verse again. O you who have believed, do not take the Jews and the Christians as allies. They are allies of one another. And in Surah 582, the most intense of the people in animosity toward the Muslims will be the Jews and Christians, those who associate others with Allah. Remember, this is the accusation of the polytheists. We associate others with Allah. So he's now saying that Jews and Christians are the most intense in their animosity toward Muslims. Then he contradicts himself. Nearest of them in affection to the believers or Muslims are those who say, we are Christians. So the Christians are both the most intense of the people in animosity toward Muslims, and they are those nearest in affection to the Muslims. Notice the confusion. Christians are described as both. Islam claims the Allah of Muhammad is the same God Jews and Christians already worship. Surah 2, 139. Say unto the people of the scripture, which is code for Jews and Christians, dispute you with us concerning Allah when he is our Lord and your Lord. Ours are our works, and yours your works. We look to him alone. Notice Islam claims Christians and Jews are polytheists. then claims Allah is also the God we worship, our Lord. What's up with that? Islam claims all believers, Jews and Christians, were really Muslims in the past. Surah 2:135. They say, be Jews or Christians, you will be guided. Say rather, the religion of Abraham inclining toward truth, and he was not of the polytheists. Surah 2:140. Or say ye that Abraham and Ishmael and Isaac and Jacob and the tribes were Jews or Christians? See, he's trying to claim that the tribes were not Jews. The 12 tribes of Israel were not Jews. The Quran tries to claim all these men in history were Muslims, then mocks Jews and Christians for claiming they were actually Jews. The Quran taunts Jews for claiming the Jewish prophets were Jews. Sweet! Surah 2:140. Or say ye that Abraham and Ishmael and Isaac and Jacob and the 12 tribes of Israel were Jews or Christians? Actually, Ishmael should not be included in that list. Jews and Christians do not consider Ishmael a legitimate heir of Abraham. Certainly not a Jew or a Christian. No one will ever claim Ishmael was a Christian. No one will ever claim Ishmael was a Jew. Think about it. This is another error in the Quran, claiming Jews and Christians lump Ishmael as either a Jew or a Christian. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Clearly examining the claims Islam makes against Christianity, we'll need more than one video.